If you're considering electronic medical records, it's a jungle out there. So how do you even know where to begin? The whole process can be overwhelming, but you don't need a complicated, deliverables-based work breakdown structure to get started. When our practice started, I wished for an easy-to-follow, 10-step plan you could wrap your brain around that was written by a fellow physician, not someone wanting to crawl in my wallet and stay there. Hi, this is Peter J. Pollack, MD. You may know me for my EMR and practice management blog, medicalpracticetrends.com, or the technology column I write for Ophthalmology Management Magazine. I wrote Navigating the EMR Jungle, 10 Steps to Ensure a Proper EMR Rollout to help physicians and practice administrators jumpstart their EMR implementation. We've sold hundreds of copies, and the book is available on Amazon.com. But in the next 2 minutes, I'll give you a sneak peek inside the book and tell you how you can download the audiobook for free. In step one, you discover why you first need to decide to do something and have a game plan in order to ensure the success of your EMR project. In step two, it's on to how to assess your facility infrastructure, a critical step which is often overlooked. Learning a few basic technical terms and concepts can help you avoid getting ripped off. Step two also tells you how to assess your staff for competencies that they'll need to have, plus a glimpse into what they'll need to know before going paperless. Step three is when you'll form an EMR committee to ensure you get buy-in from all the important stakeholders and how to leverage your committee's help in the onerous task of vetting the EMR software vendors. Most critical so far will be step four. You'll see why it's important to get all your doctors involved and how to deal with a potential saboteur. Step five is where every novice thinks they should start, and if they skip those first four, they live to regret it. You know the old saying, I don't have time to do it right, but I have time to do it twice. That's why you don't do step five first. Once done, you'll be able to create a short list of vendors based on input from your EMR committee and learn how to avoid making an expensive mistake. You plan your implementation in step six, along with how to decide the best way to roll out an EMR in your practice. There are several critical decisions in this step, so listen carefully. In step seven, you'll see the importance of organizing a training schedule using the train the trainer method, making your super users feel indispensable, and the importance of training audits. Often skipped is step eight. You'll begin to understand what's so critical about running a real live simulation day, not just a dry lab, and how it's your last chance to get all the bugs worked out before you're dealing with live patients. In step nine, you'll discover the most exciting thing that should happen on your go-live day. Last step, build on your successes. We'll show you how to assess your current processes and plan for expansion of your EMR rollout. And that's it. If you want to buy the book, feel free to visit Amazon.com. But if you want to download a free version of the audiobook, fill out your name and email, and we'll send you the first chapters right away.